Good morning, good morning. Hey, isn't it great to stay up late? Good morning to you and you and you and you and you. Good morning, Gabriella, Joyce Pritchard, Sue K, Angela Thompson, Mel W, Fiona, Eamon, Jack, Sally, Xander, and Nicola, Anastasia, and Sally O'Hool.
This is us seeming like we're really happy.
Good morning.
Really happy, really
good
carefree.
Good morning, Vietnam.
Really sort of at ease with the fact that our lives are a fucking mess.
Good morning, good morning.
I just need to sing this song. Good morning, good morning to you and me and you.
And you and you and you and you. The reason we're doing this is we are totally demotivated. We're utterly fucked off with everything. So we thought we'd just cheer you in with this first thing.
But I just want to look into Joe Biden's twinkly little blue eyes.
He looks so weird.
I want to look into those dark blue eyes. Those eyes, America. Welcome, America. I've won. I've won, America. He has won. It's clear he's won. And all this nonsense around the edges is just going to have to fade away. Or we're going to have to get DHL in and they're going to have to escort Trump out.
Yeah, but to be fair, he's not supposed to go yet.
What do you mean?
I do think.
Hey, who's not supposed to go yet? No, look, Trump's there another 3 months. I bet you any money he's going to take a shit behind the sofa.
Do you think he might storm off early?
I think he's going to wreck the place.
Oh, don't say
he
that.
He is. He's going to leave all sorts of... He's going to put bogeys under the Oval Desk. He's going to do all sorts of terrible things.
Chewing gum and a bogey.
Chewing gum, yeah. He's going to put things behind things.
Ooh.
He's going to do what I used to do when I didn't like one of my mum's partners because she was horrible. I used to put drawing pins, sellotape underneath the little drawer handle so she couldn't sneak in and look at my diary. He's going to do that.
Did you?
Yeah.
Say that again.
Yeah. You just said shush and then you're now telling me to say it again.
No, I thought you were going to say the other thing.
I used to, because I had like a private diary and I had letters from my girlfriend and things like that and I didn't want no one to read them because they were dirty actually. I used to put, what are they called? What are the drawing pins under the handles of my drawers, sellotaped, so that if someone, even if she chose to have a look, it would hurt. I did one where I had this elaborate piece of string and rope and a hammer that came sliding down.
She wasn't the least bit interested.
Just being the ships, two people have a right row over one not wearing a mask, everyone turning on one. Just being to the shops, two people having an outright row over one not wearing a mask. In Wales, someone pulled a gun.
No.
On someone for challenging them for not wearing a mask. Yeah, absolutely.
In Wales. Now, that's exactly what I was saying to you this morning, isn't it? That I just feel like...
Chicken tonight?
Fundamentally changed. There's a violence in the air that I just... If I'm really honest about how I'm feeling at the moment, I feel really unnerved. I feel like a darkness inside me.
Sit down and share it with us, babe.
I do.
No, sit down and open up.
I'm guessing
not. I have a dark, tarry feeling in my chest.
Yeah,
I have a feeling of it's not even... Okay, let me explain to you what this is. I'm not even worried. I mean, I'm worried about the disease for those people for whom are vulnerable from it. I believe it. I don't think it's the flu. I'm not one of those people who's a COVID denier. I believe it is what it is, and I worry about it. I'm just more worried about the mental health of the nation. I'm just worried about how we... Even if this was to vaporize and disappear tomorrow, how we pick ourselves up and dust ourselves down. I'm sure there's a song in there somewhere. I'm sure Nadia will oblige at some point. Here she comes. Oh, thank God, she didn't have one at the tip of her tongue. You know, I can see its different impacts on people like Nanny Di, on the girls, obviously, on my older girls, Fleur in Manchester, Izzy in Bristol. And you just think there are then the further ramifications, just a change in sort of jobs and all that kind of stuff. So, yeah, waking up on a Saturday feeling deflated when all of the effing scientific evidence is telling us we don't need to be in a lockdown.
Well, not all.
Well, a lot.
Come on, be balanced.
Well, share with us.
Well, there are some scientists.
Suggesting that the R rates come down with plateau.
And it's not necessarily them saying, oh, God, everything's, you know, bloody hell, what are we all doing? But I feel a bit for Boris with this, But actually, I think it seems that a lot of scientists are saying the tear system was working really well.
John Campbell was saying it all along.
And that the R rate is down to one, which is where it was when we came out of lockdown before. Not everywhere, but in certain parts of the country.
You said somewhere that someone was suggesting that we may have to go into a two-week lockdown as the price
Sage.
For Christmas.
Apparently something's leaked by Sage. But, you know, I think we've got to watch all these leaks. I mean, you know. I mean, I think we're all aware that there's going to be mini lockdowns going on until we've got a vaccine. Mm. But that's what the tier system was. Little lockdown three here, going to tier two, come back to tier one. It seems kind of reasonable as an idea that.
Faith Goodman, haven't seen that story, but I will find it. Someone apparently had loads of thrown out boxed Star Wars figures in a skip, discovered they were worth $250,000.
No.
Boom, shakalaka, boom. That's why all of those kind of collectibles are investables. I love this. Things that you do to get back at the incoming people. So Antonia Schwartz here has, I rubbed milk under the tables in the science lab on my last day of secondary school. I hated my science teachers. They were horrible to me. The smell over the summer holidays must have been putrid.
Oh my God, I love that.
So I wonder if Trump might leave his orange stain sort of, I don't know, you know, tan marks everywhere. I wonder what Melania Trump... Did you hear this, though? Apparently, in the presidency, Melania Trump took it upon herself to cut down all of the apple orchard trees that other first ladies had put in.
I read that. Do you think that's true? I was so horrified by that. I thought it was just fake news.
Astonishing.
Do you think that's true? Come on, give us some other things that you would do to somebody that
have you...
revenge?
Have you ever taken revenge by doing something inanimate to a place? Like, you've left something and thought...
I placed a couple of my ex-boyfriend's favourite albums under the wheels of his car, so when he reversed out the
driveway. Oh, yes, I heard about that. Don't ever think of doing that with my jazz vinyl.
Well, just don't ever cross me.
Yeah, you've got nothing that you'd worry about being run over, would you? I mean, I couldn't even take an item of clothing of yours. What have you got that you value that's an object? Not even your wedding ring, you don't wear that anymore.
The paintings that you've done me and the girls have done
me. I'm not going to be such a bastard as to destroy my children's paintings.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm safe. I'm not one for things.
Objet d'art.
I mean, all my the things that you've bought me, the lovely pieces of art and stuff.
Shredded my estranged passport. Really... Oh, that's a good one. I shredded my estranged husband's passport, Emery Evans. That is pretty
good. I love the way she shredded it. Yeah. She didn't just put it in the bin.
And then did you send it back to him? Laura Taylor, you're right. The Secret Service have designated Joe Biden former vice president status to president-elect. That will be driving Trump. I wonder if that means now there are security guards going, nah, sorry, Donald, I've got to look after him. I mean, obviously, they've got to look after the current president. I mean, let's not forget, he's president for another 3 months. Trump.
Yeah.
Yeah. I reckon he's going to do all sorts of shit in the White House.
Yeah.
He's going to smear stuff on walls and he's going to sort of leave things in drawers.
Anastasia says, my husband knows his vinyls will get it if he pisses me off.
Wow. Wow.
Wipe my ass with their toothbrush, says Mary Tolbert.
You did not. I thought that was... a friend of mine who went to Glastonbury or Reading had, when they had all been out, they returned to their tent. This must be something that happens at festivals. And when they returned to their tent to find their toothbrushes, in their wash bag was a Polaroid of some guy with them all rammed up his ass.
Oh my God, that's a bit much. That's a bit much.
He had the cleanest ass in Glastonbury.
Star Wars figures stories on BBC.
I'll have a look at that. My husband works in Bristol. He finished work yesterday at 7 p.m. and said roads were way busier than normal for Friday night, so clearly people aren't staying. No, they're not. Nothing is happening.
No, but I mean, this just makes me cross for the people with all the small businesses that can't be open.
Ooh.
Just let them open.
That's crazy, crazy.
I just want us to go back to the tier system. Who thinks we should go back to the tier system?
Mm.
Who else is feeling unmotivated? Let's talk a bit about motivation and how we can maybe encourage each other.
Yeah, motivation. Because
we're feeling unmotivated.
Right, I struggle. Yeah, when my eyes first open, I want to get up and get on, but I have that absolute depression thing that I've rarely ever suffered from in depression. I've rarely had that thing where I just want to shut the curtains, stay in bed and have such a lethargy and an inability to get up. But I do, if I had no responsibilities and no commitments, I would do that. I would do that. I would just stay there. And so I
you
worry.
Though.
Well, no, I probably wouldn't. But the point is that the feeling is so extreme and so real, and much more than...
I feel like in the morning, emotionally and physically, I'm like an old, battered car that I have to try and jumpstart to get going.
Yeah, with leather, old smashed leather upholstery.
Because everything feels so meaningless when you look at... Doesn't it? It's just like you said, like my laundry room, that's such a bloody tip that I've got to do, and I think, oh, I'll tidy it up, but what does it really mean? What difference does it actually make? Everything is like, what difference does it make?
I think there's something, I think a depression has crept in. Does anyone else agree? A bit of a depression has crept in because I think we've all, however sophisticated we are, however questioning we are, however much we sort of feel we're politically plugged in, I think we've been, it's been demonstrated to us how ineffective and useless and just ordinarily human our governments are and the authorities are. And because I don't feel anything that they're doing at the moment is necessarily appropriate or right. I don't sit there going, oh yeah, no, that thing. I haven't once sat there and gone, brilliant, they've done that. Haven't thought that once in the whole thing. And I think there's a sort of depression that creeps in from that because it's like realizing your parents don't know everything.
They don't know anything.
Or, yeah, not don't know everything, which is one stage of being a child with a parent, but this one's now they don't know anything.
Yeah, the lockdown blues, somebody said. We got a little bit of lockdown blues.
I think we should try and motivate.
Yeah, that's what I was just thinking. Somebody just said the lockdown blues. Yeah. I like that.
Sitting on the edge of a huge precipice.
Precipice.
Can't think of a word that rhymes with precipice other than piss.
Oh, Mark.
But if we wake up in the morning and we pull up our duvet, look down at our legs and see some movement, it's a good feeling.
It's a good feeling.
Don't know where it's
going.
Isolation stinks. Isolation stinks. Ooh, and now we've got the funny minx.
Don't talk about the minx.
I want to use a mink like a microphone.
The mink situation.
It's a minxy situation in Europe.
It's a minxy situation.
I wonder if there's anyone, is there somewhere? Is somewhere God sitting there, and I'm not advocating this at all, but is he sitting there, as Robin Williams once said in his New York live show, is God sitting up there with a great big fat joint going, right, the bats have got him, but now, let's get the minx. Let's get the minx. I mean, it's freaking ridiculous.
Says, the minx story broke my vegan heart. I think the minx story is yet another situation that is being shoved into humanity's face to say, what the hell are we actually doing? 15 million minx, apparently they're kept in really bad, cramped together. So, of course, the fucking coronavirus has gone through them like a...
Yeah.
Well, it's mutated and gone through them.
We don't necessarily know if it's mutated badly. I mean, there is a story saying they don't actually know that.
Well, I watched John Campbell yesterday because he's the voice of reason. Thank you, Faith Goodman, for recommending Faith Goodman. And he... for recommending him. And this is what he said about it. He said, it's mutated. We don't know yet what that means. Okay? It could mean that the vaccines won't work for it. It could mean that it could be another pandemic.
Could be that it's less virulent than this one.
Could be that it's less virulent. He said, we don't know. He said, but, and he was saying, I urge all of you to contact your MPs and...
Plandemic. Okay.
And urge them to push... Is it Simon Schatz? What's his name? To insist that people that have isolating, that have come back from Denmark, it has to be an enforced isolation. And he gave the analogy that if you were going around a hairpin bend and you weren't sure what was round the other side, it would be really good to just slow down your car rather than put your foot on the accelerator and go down round. And he said, effectively, that's what's happening. So yesterday, he read out a great long list of all the flights that were coming out of Denmark around the world, Doha, Egypt.
We have an absolute ban to hear that.
German. Yeah, but as from 4 o'clock yesterday, there were still people...
I agree. It's taking too long. Yeah.
And so the ruling has been, in this country, as from 4 o'clock yesterday, anyone returning from Denmark must self-isolate, not isolate within their home, for 14 days. And as John Campbell said, People don't. Some people won't. You know, you said we had Dominic Cummings nipping over to see his dad. We had, you know, the Scottish minister, health minister, nipping to her country weekend. People don't stay in for those 14 days. And he said he's getting the feeling of Wuhan in January.
Yeah, can I just say, a couple of people asking what the mink story is. Yes, it has transferred over to humans. 17 humans in Denmark have tested.
I've got the new.
And they're doing intense, as are the British scientists, are intensely exploring and examining it.
Yeah.
Sharona, you did say you had news. We did ask what it was, and you may have answered, and it may have flown up so far. So if you do answer again, you might have to answer a couple of times so that we can see it.
So, you know, it's just, we don't know what's going to happen with it, but it seems sensible, after everything that we've learned, to close borders and to make sure that it doesn't spread.
Just until they've got a grip on it.
Exactly, that's what John Campbell said. He said, we don't know, but until we do know, let's be extra cautious. Mm.
Emma Staple, this is a very striking image you paint of your mum, Emma Staple. My mum told a statue of Santa that was singing Christmas songs to fuck off this morning. Life in 2020. I'm going to hold that image, Emma. Very, very. Tell your mum, she's an absolute legend. A legend. She's a legend. Someone's had a go at writing a ditty, I think, somewhere.
I really want to put the Christmas decorations up soon. Louise Pentland, who I follow on Instagram, and she's lovely, and she's had the full works done in her house, and oh my God,
here we go.
So lovely.
Kirsty Wilson, it's lockdown too, don't feel blue. Watch Coffee Moaning, make sure you do. It's so much fun with Mark and Nad. When they're around, you can't feel bad.
Oh, we like Kirstie. It. We'll have to put some music to that.
Yeah, we'll get Nadia to now sing it from memory.
It's lockdown too, don't feel blue. It's lockdown too, Mark and Nad. It's lockdown too, don't feel blue. Watch Coffee Morning, make sure you do. It's so much fun with Mark and Dad.
Oh my God, I'm having flashbacks to when we tried to do the Dancing Queen.
Oh God, do you remember that?
The girls came in the other day and they said, Dad, Mum, Dad, that was your low watermark, benchmark of your YouTube adventure.
Bad.
We now employ Maddie and Kiki as consultants, by the way,
yeah,
to guide us on
we
our
do. We literally
through.
Go, what do you think of this? Yeah. Sometimes you film stuff and they say, do not, under any circumstances, post that.
Sometimes I walk and say, Maddie, I'm thinking of saying this today. And she goes, oh! That's all she does.
Guys, can I ask you, you know how you all love on my Instagram, me doing like the piss takes of celebrities, like dressed in whatever, dressed or undressed, whatever.
It's the nearest I get to seeing you naked. I love it.
If there's anything you fancy me having a go at doing or lip syncing, send me it, DM me it on Instagram. Okay, I'm going to do one for tonight.
Lee wants to see what our suggestions are, to see the girls' reaction. That's not a bad idea. We could bleep out our suggestions, couldn't we? So, Sharona, have you come through with what your news is? I'm not seeing anything there.
Sharona.
Hey, Sharona. Oh, what is that smell of delicious, fabulous food
in the
God, background?
Oh, my God, it's so good. I'd show you. Could you...
It's Mediterranean fish.
No, but also it's the potatoes.
Oh my God. You're not going to believe it. They're my potatoes. Nad has played with my spuds today in the kitchen. She really has.
Oh, my God.
Oliver Masterson.
They are so good. This is for the No Name Sunday show.
For the No Name Sunday show is going on over there. Though, of course, it isn't because I'm not filming it. Can I just say, Oliver Masterson, you make an interesting point. How are you, by the way? Donald to come back in 4 years to try and run again. Do you think he will? I think he might be in prison by then.
Mark, you can't say that.
No, he might be. I think
you know, there's a lot of talk about him being in dire financial straits.
Oh, yeah.
Here's a question, Mark. You might know the answer. You know how he hasn't paid tax the whole time he's been president? Will he now, when he's no longer president, be called to court for that?
Yeah, I mean, I think all of his, but also his loans and everything else. I mean, his whole empire is under inquiry. So I think that whole, I don't know if it's on pause necessarily
whilst
he's president.
I wondered.
So it could accelerate quickly. I think we're going to find there's a whole heap, a molehill, a mound, a mountain.
I don't think he'll run again.
Of stuff that's going to sort of keep him basically clogged up in the courts.
Xander
Gibbs,
excuse me, quite right. Xander, can you answer Xander? Xander said, in prison for what? You can't just say something like that.
No, that's true. I can't just say something like that.
It was outrageous.
Okay, I take it back. You can't say that. But, I mean, I think there's a feeling. I think if Nancy Pelosi had her way, she'd throw everything
I think there's a suggestion, isn't there, Xander, because he hasn't paid his tax.
Yeah.
I mean, I believe every person has to pay tax.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think the Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I mean, I don't know. I don't know what he could be done for. I just feel like the Democrats. I'm not even saying necessarily that he should go to prison. I just think that the Democrats are so desperate to get him. And I've actually been, Xander, I've been actually very, very critical of the way in which the Democrats have only gone for him in a sort of almost blind way, without actually just hitting him on policy. And I think that. You know, I think the worry that he might have is that they're just going to try. I mean, he's been peppered and peppered and peppered and peppered. And I think that that peppering will just carry on. It will just carry on beyond it. It's not necessarily that he will be or that he has done. You can't say that. You're absolutely right. But I do think that he's going to be under duress for a period of time.
I think the tax thing might come
by.
Yeah,
I think it might.
Cada Girl has asked if we can sing happy birthday to 12-year-old Dylan. And of course we can. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Dylan. Happy birthday to...
Oh, God almighty. You.
And guys, if you are new to the channel, I can see some names I haven't seen before. Please hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you can never miss a thing that we post.
Absolutely. Entirely agree, Xander. Entirely agree. Brenda McGee, welcome. Nora, where's... is that where we were just singing to? Teresa Lockwood, dance... Oh, my God, I can't dance this morning. My back is killing me from filming the Sunday show. I've gone under such duress. Please call out Anna's name.
I think Trump will go back to telly.
I think he might.
I think he'll have a huge reality show of some sort, and he'll make his money back and he'll pay his tax.
Yeah, absolutely.
And get himself out of this mess. He's one of those people.
Sharona, you haven't come through with your news. We have begged and begged. Tell us your news, Sharona. I don't want you feeling that...
Sharona. Right, Scotland banned smacking. I need to know about
this. Yeah, did you know about this?
No, I don't
know anything about this.
This is a big news story. I'm really happy with the sound of that.
So... they are the first country. Terribly sad story about. Hang on, let me just find it on the internet, on the old-fashioned internet.
Internet
bans. So what are we doing later? How are you finding night shift, guys?
They can't speak. We always forget they can't speak.
Scotland becomes first UK nation to ban smacking children. Changes to the law give children the same protection from assault as adults, passed by the Scottish Parliament and take effect from Saturday.
Wow.
58th country in the world to outlaw corporal punishment for anyone under 16. What's your feeling about that, Ned?
Well, I mean...
Share your thoughts!
I respect that some people it feel it's right, but personally, I think when you hit a child, you're teaching a child that it's okay to hit.
Mm.
And when people give the reason that, well, listen, when you're not being able to get through to your child and they need to understand and you smack them and that helps them understand, I think somewhere in there you're teaching them, when you can't make somebody understand or agree with you, you smack them.
Yeah.
Also, if I were to see a great big guy hitting a smaller guy, we'd all be outraged.
Mm.
And I think I just feel the same way about children.
Mm.
I don't like to see anyone hit anyone.
No. No,
it
agree.
Really upsets me. If I see someone hitting their child out, I get really...
My God,
it haunts me all day long. I was smacked as a child, hated it. It never worked. All it did was I would go up to my room and I would hate my... I'm just talking 70s smacked. I wasn't beaten or anything like that. Just the old-fashioned way, you know. And all it ever did was make me lie, because I would lie. So I would say, yeah, I'm really sorry, Mum. And inside I'd be going, I hate you, I hate you, I hate you. So, and it caused resentment. And it never made, I don't think it ever made me a better person.
Mm.
Made me an angry person.
No, I agree. And I think, we did a Confessions of a Modern Parent on this. And I think it's not just, I mean, the thing is, there can be corporal punishment of children as well. That's not just physical. I mean, you know,
I think really, really shouting
against
at
it. Yeah,
a
yeah,
child
shouting
is,
at a child
is really shouting, as they say, is just as bad.
Just to clarify, I wasn't wearing an apron in the original thumbnail. I had the camera around my neck. Faith's asking why I was wearing it. I certainly wasn't cooking. I was filming cooking, though. Why are you wearing an apron? So what we talked about, Danish mink, Scotland bans, when will Trump concede?
So it's still legal in England, isn't it?
I think it is, yeah, absolutely.
But you mustn't leave a mark or something weird like that.
Yeah. Michelle Armstrong, night shift is cracking as I miss most coffee mornings. Good. We're really enjoying them too. It's a sort of an escape. And you've probably noticed at that point in the night, you know, all kind of inhibitions have gone out the window, haven't they? Yeah. Really? I mean, you never know what you're going to get when you come to us. I mean, it could be anything. I mean, Nadja could be up to anything.
That's our potatoes. That's our potatoes.
That's
Mark
Spuds ready to go.
And if anyone wants to join us on the No Name Sunday show, you can just go to the join button on below for the members area. We now do a members live every week. We do the No Name Sunday show, which is usually about an hour, between an hour and a half every Sunday. And we also do a reading out your comments film as well. So those are the extras that you get in the family guest area.
Oh.
So if you fancy joining us, I'm sure all the family guests here will say that they love it.
And I do want to say once again, Sharona, I haven't seen your news.
What has happened for Sharona?
Yeah, because you're going to ask again tomorrow.
Can somebody tell us what happened with Sharona?
So probably the best bet, Sharona, is tell us underneath this once it's uploaded. And then
some
we'll be
people
able to read
asking
it.
Us, what time is the night shift tonight?
Any time after 10.
Yeah.
We're not on a fixed time, are we, necessarily?
No, because I tell you why. We don't like to suddenly pull out from the kids if we're watching something or something. Mm. So we try and, sometime.
Oh, look, Claire.
Hopefully 10, but it might be later. But we'll leave a story on YouTube and on Instagram.
Claire.
Oh, are we doing a live later?
Claire Yardley Coco, my first Sunday show tomorrow. Can't wait to watch.
Oh. Well, don't forget, Claire Yardley, there's loads of 42 or 43 others that you can watch because they're all left up there so you can backdate them.
It's Billy Boozy. Welcome to family guest area. Billy Boozy.
Oh, it's Billy Boozy. It's Billy Boozy. Oh, welcome Billy Boozy to the game.
Hey, hey.
Billy Boozy. It's Billy Boozy.
Oh,
welcome.
Just
welcome,
that has done
welcome,
my back.
Welcome. Group hug for everyone.
Welcome, it's Billy
Boozy.
We
are doing a regular
else.
Thing on the night shift now. So if you're new, make sure you hit the subscribe button so you know when we're... Can you get us to 200 thumbs up, please, guys? We're at 171.
Oh.
Come on.
Oh, Miss Beautilicious 100. My dog's being put down today. Sending you... Oh, that's so
no.
sad.
Oh, God, that's
We've
horrendous.
Been, we were very close. We were very close to that. So many apologies.
Yeah.
Keep the chat friendly. We like to embrace all colours of the political spectrum. So a nice big group hug. And
every night now on night shift, we will end the night shift with the song Kumbaya. So if you want to brush up on your lyrics, we will be expecting you to all sing from home.
Yeah, we might have a candle and we might have incense. Mm. But incense always used to give me asthma. Kiki has incense wherever I go upstairs. Is incense good or bad for
Wonder people? Woman says, I hope Melania finds her voice, divorces Trump and does a tell-all with
now,
Oprah.
Now, that's a really interesting point there.
Really
interesting. Because maybe that's where his biggest vulnerability lies, with Melania.
Kirsty Wilson, I'm the girl who sent you the... At the bottom?
The poem on Insta.
Oh,
yes,
thank you.
You.
We loved it.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I think Trump has lost the plot. He's a bad loser. Yeah, it's a tricky one, isn't it? Melania's probably tightening up her prenup.
Stand by me when you're not strong. Steph likes this.
I'll be your friend.
Somebody to lean on.
Lean on.
Goodbye, everybody.
Take care, guys.
See you tonight.
See you tonight for more insanity.
Oh,